I'm really excited. I have Dr. Sam Bunting with me today. She is a London dermatologist. She has looked after many of my clients and I come to her for lots and lots of advice. I want to ask her today about teenage skin. So please, when I research things for my friends or my own children, my sons, I'm bombarded with information, salicylic, benzoyl peroxide, I never really get to the point of actually finding you should buy this product and it will do this. Stage one, so like first pimples.
Yep.
They're getting quite nervous about it, redness in the skin. What can we do?
So I think the first thing is, so the first signs tend to be clogged pores, so blackheads, yes. Whiteheads, which
so
are
do they extract those?
Pardon?
Do we extract those straight away?
No extraction. So my philosophy is that if you don't normalize the process which is causing the problems, you never get ahead of the problem. You're always just reacting to it, which inevitably right. doesn't mean some blemishes. So what you need to put into place is, firstly, a structured skincare regime, which for a lot of teens, they use a little bit of this, a little bit of that, whatever mm-hmm. their friends are using. So simple, clean products which don't clog the pores. Mm-hmm. So brands like Cetaphil, La Roche-Posay, Bioderma, Avène. So a simple cleanser.
French brands.
Exactly. They just tend to be well formulated with very few irritants, and they support barrier function. They don't dry the skin out too much. I'm not a fan of foaming cleansers. So keep everything nice
Why
and
is
neutral.
That?
Well, excessive oil. Of course, that is part of the problem. That's what happens mm-hmm. in puberty. The oil glands get switched on. But the reality is that anything that really helps correct the acne process is inherently quite drying, so you don't want to make it even harder to tolerate those products mm-hmm. by drying the skin out first by using a foaming cleanser.
Okay, that makes sense.
Because most people have combination skin, so normal skin in their cheeks, which means you end up with dry, tight skin, which won't tolerate the acne medications very well. The single commonest reason why acne treatment fails is because people give up too soon. They don't comply with it for long enough.
Okay.
And you're improving the skin over the course of months, no matter what we use.
And that seems like forever.
It does seem like a long time. It's two skin cycles. 4 to 6 weeks is a skin cycle. So you have to give the new layer of skin time to be exposed to the balancing ingredients before you can really
expect
change.
4 to 6 weeks, that's a great tip.
But then that's where your expertise with how to kind of manage the skin in the here and now. I'm all for quick fixes that give people confidence so they can stick with the routine. It's like personal training. It hurts before it gets better. So I think if you have that in mind, A, you don't go in too hard and too fast with active ingredients and turn your skin into a red, sore mess. So acne plus eczema. Mm-hmm. And you can be measured about it. So that's your goalpost, is to think about improvement over the course of 3 months.
So you follow the regime, and I know each of those brands have specific products for an irritated, acne-prone skin.
Yeah.
Would you then go in with something to actually eradicate the spot?
So what I tend to recommend is, first and foremost, you must unclog the pores.
Mm-hmm.
We only have a few ingredients to do that. The most important one is a retinoid. So on prescription, that's something like Differin gel, which contains a synthetic
retinoid. Which you can get over-the-counter in America.
In America, exactly. And over-the-counter in the UK, brands like Avène and La Roche-Posay do have retinoid-based treatments. They're gentler, but you know they're going to be helpful at preventing that first step, which is the formation of clogged pores. They also help exfoliate and refine, so if you've got some dark marks from previous spots, they help improve the appearance of those too. So it's a win-win. Then I agree. So that's always a nighttime step, because retinoids tend to be inactivated by ultraviolet. So the logical thing is then to treat the spots in the here and now in the morning. So that's where you have space for an anti-inflammatory like salicylic acid or benzoyl peroxide or azelaic acid. So that is the way I structure routines in the practice for patients on prescription medications. The same philosophy applies for over-the-counter products.
Which one would you choose in that, those active ingredients?
It kind of depends on the skin type. I think, honestly, benzoyl peroxide is the most effective. But then it becomes important that the formulation is good. And it's actually currently very hard in the UK to get good formulations. On prescription, we have benzoyl peroxide well formulated in something called Duac, because the base is quite hydrating, so it's a lot less harsh than maybe we remember. I remember certainly benzoyl peroxide in my teenage years.
So reading between the lines, Sam, would your advice be, as soon as your skin starts to turn, you get a lot of clogged pores, maybe go straight to a GP?
I think if it's active enough to be leaving significant marks behind, that you're getting new blemishes most days, that is certainly something to consider, because it's amazing how much heartache and misery you'll save yourself by just getting a good system in place first. If it's milder, it's just some oiliness, some comedones, blackheads, maybe a few red blemishes, then I think it's perfectly reasonable to try something with salicylic acid in the morning and the retinoid step at night. And there are quite a few preparations with salicylic acid. We should look for 1-2%. There's a product from a brand called Medicate called Beta Gel that I'm really fond of as an over-the-counter preparation. It contains a little bit of salicylic acid and azelaic acid, which is again good for getting rid of the dark marks. More accessible, perhaps, is La Roche-Posay's Effaclar Duo, which has a great rep as being quite gentle, but again, good for that anti-inflammatory effect.
Okay, absolutely fascinating. Hopefully, I've definitely learned 3 or 4 things from talking to you now, so hopefully that's beneficial. And if you want to follow Sam, please follow on YouTube, Dr. Sam Bunting, and we will have more from Sam very soon.